base from Assassin's Creed Brotherhood and talk to you guys about Assassin's Creed Origin. See, it's taunting me. Anyway, where to start? I successfully pre-ordered Assassin's Creed Origin, the deluxe edition. Because not only am I super, super excited to play the next chapter of Assassin's Creed, I've been following this game nonstop since I heard about it. And I can honestly say I am super, super excited. There is only 12 days away until it's released. Now, what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to want to do some broadcasting. That's definitely something I want to do. But also, at the same token, it's more of a personal thing for me because, I mean, I'm not going to lie, I'm a bit of an Assassin's Creed fanboy. I love the series, I love the story, and I cannot wait to see what they're bringing in to Origin with ancient Egypt, the modern day. That is one of the largest things I want to emphasize on. The modern day story. Some people think it's going to be Desmond's son. That is the case. That would be awesome. Also, I'm going to see Sean again. I'm going to see Rebecca again. I know Desmond's body. Technically. Well, Desmond's body. He's considered. So, there's that. I'm really sorry I'm recording so late. It's just, I've been hunting all over YouTube. It's horrible for me to say this. But I've been hunting all over YouTube trying to catch a glimpse of anything on the modern day story. But, as usual, something I want to keep on hush hush, at least until the end.
Must be a drunken wager or something.
Because, you know, I want to know, technically, I should be asleep. It is fairly late. But, anyway, the cool thing about Origins that it's going to be the largest map to date. As a matter of fact, after doing some research, the masterminds behind AC4 are the same ones that are taking on Origin, so that's really cool. It's neat that they want to, tackle this project. This project's gonna be huge. I was watching an interview with the leading developer. Basically him talking about the storyline. Something I noticed is that every time that anybody asks about the modern day, he shuts it down. Just severely shuts it down. Fair. Like, the only question I really want answered is that the modern day story, is it going to be like a storyline similar to Desmond's? Not being Desmond's, just similar. You know, you have your main protagonist, jumps in an animus, and all that. That'd be cool. I would love him to bring that back because I was disappointed with AC4's. I mean, you know, the gameplay was amazing. Hands down, best Assassin's Creed game to date.
I think
Origins
is
definitely coming in close second for taking the top. Anywho, like, basically everything I'm saying about Origins, everything that I've heard, everything that, you know, I'd like to see. I mean, I know with all the other Assassin's Creed games that they've brought legacy outfits, which are neat. You know, it's always cool to have legacy outfits. Legacy outfits are definitely, like, something that you'll be like, aw, that's so cool. Which is, you know, something that I would love to see. Like, not even kidding. Like, this is gonna sound probably a little silly or a little outrageous, but whatever. A suit that I want to see, I would like for them to put Aguilar's outfit in the game. I don't think they will, though. They gotta put some sort of Easter egg
for now.
But I doubt it. But I mean, like, with them basically tackling, which potentially could be the largest, you know, I mean, this is going to be a huge undertaking, it's going to be a huge game, like, without a doubt. I mean, you're talking about a game that has been secretly being made since right after AC4. And I'm even ashamed to say that I did not know anything about it. I mean, obviously, you know, this was a big project, you know, a big world. It's going to be diverse and dynamic, just like how Unity and Syndicate were. Even though Unity did have its lag, a lot of people would agree that it was not great. I mean, honestly, if you look at every Assassin's Creed game, every game in some way, shape, or form had its flaw. Had something about it that made it, had something about it that made it, like, making people just want to shut it down, because, I mean, everybody is entitled to their opinions, obviously. I mean, we're only human after all. Anyway, but with this enormous undertaking of Assassin's Creed Origin, the birth of the Brotherhood, and just being, I mean, probably one of my favorite things about Assassin's Creed, just let alone from the history and the time frame, is the faces, the historical figures. I mean, Assassin's Creed got me into liking history. And, I mean, a lot of things that I've referenced to my friends, which, whenever they ask me about, like, an Assassin's Creed game, you know, the time that, you know, took place, the time frame, the, I mean, I love Brotherhood, that's what I'm playing right now, but it is killing me about the fact that I gotta wait 12 more days.
How about coiling that corpse? You are not going anywhere!
I mean, when it comes out, I for sure am going to be called out. Like, when they come out with the warning, like, I do want to make YouTube a career for myself. But at the same token, you know, in the meantime, I do so I mean, obviously I will be, you know, playing the game when I can. But you know, like when I mean I'm thinking for like my first playthrough. First playthrough, you know, I mean, just basically for myself, you know. I mean, I do want to broadcast gameplay, but I want to, you know, be able to enjoy the game for myself before I start recording, because, you know, this is a game that series that I take a lot of pride in. I enjoy the series. I enjoy the story. The story is, you know, definitely, the story's always been something that I've enjoyed, which is why I've always enjoyed Assassin's Creed ones, because of the tremendous stories that they tell, the characters that are talked about, like Origen, we're going to be seeing Cleopatra, Caesar, and hell, you never know, there might even be other things that we don't know. Modern day, they're being extremely quiet about. I've been trying to hunt down any information about the modern day that I could, and there is nothing. There's theories, but there's no legitimate. There's not viable information that could be used. Be like, oh yeah, you know, this is the modern day. This is what it's going to be about. And that's the part that is just really frustrating to me, because deep down, I want to know. I mean, I really do. Ah, right. I mean, I want to be able to... Hold on a second. I want to be able to sit down, enjoy the gameplay. Now, obviously, I don't know how long the game's going to be. What all, you know, I mean, I know there's going to be a lot of side quests. There's going to be a lot of... I mean, the map's huge. I just read today about that the sandstorms in the game, that, you know, the coast of the desert and there's sandstorms. You know, you're not going to get hurt by it, but it's going to reduce your visibility, which, I mean, realistically speaking, does make sense. Now, all of the stuff they've been showing for Origin has been on the Xbox One X, so I don't know how it's going to differ for the PS4. I'm going to be playing it on the PS4. I mean, it's a console I have. I mean, for my avatar, I got the Balak avatar, which, I mean, I think it's cool, so. Why it's there. My PS4's dynamic theme is the Assassin's Creed Origin. It used to be Skyrim, but I got tired of seeing the Skyrim logo. I mean, I don't even play it anymore. Because, I mean, like, I've been playing a lot more Assassin's Creed now than I have before. Part of me was thinking about, because, you know, I do have, like, 12 days before the game's released, that I would play AC4 and get AC4 beat again. How many times have I played AC4? I don't even know. But, I did pre-order the Deluxe Edition, which, pretty hefty, not the, you know, the Gold Edition, which comes with the Season Pass and everything else for $100. I mean, honestly, depending on the DLC itself for the game, I might just, I mean, hell, I could purchase the Season Pass after the game's released. Actually, that does not sound like a bad idea. Sorry about that. But, I mean, I'm not sure what DLC that they're going to be releasing. I know that because I did pre-order the game that I'm going to be getting the Secrets of the First Tomb. Which, did I? No. All the other Assassin's Creed games I did not pre-order. Actually, no. You know, if I was able to set up, you know, like, a playing area for when I play Assassin's Creed, I got Assassin's Creed game statues and stuff there. I got the AC4 flag that I got for pre-ordering the game. But what it did was, because I couldn't keep, you know, doing that, because I got the Collector's Edition for AC4. So, I mean, I got the flag. Oh no, not the flag. The flag came with the Collector's Edition. I got the poster by Seth MacFarlane. So, I mean, around my room, I got a bunch of Assassin's Creed stuff. But it'll be interesting to see what all that, you know, comes in the initial game, and then after that, like, what else that they're going to be bringing to it. I mean, I know that there's going to be a lot to this game. I'm just hoping that the lag is not as bad as it was for the lag was pretty bad in Unity. Not gonna lie, the lag was horrible in Unity. I mean, I did play through Unity. I did like Unity. Unity was really good. Syndicate wasn't bad, per se. I didn't mind Syndicate. I liked the story. I liked the fact that, you know, you had the brother and the sister. The sister was more focused on stealth. The brother, not so much. The sister was more trying to follow her father's work. Then the brother, brother was a bit of a smartass, which I did like. I thought it was funny, especially how they decided to tell the story. But yeah. But I mean, now I want to focus on my efforts. I mean, because I
care didn't for all.
So, I mean, since I do work, I will be spending time playing the game.
I've done what I could.
Not as much as I want to. Perhaps you should avoid the deeds that brought you. Day off. No, the day off. Will be legitimately all over it. Like, there will be no joke to how much I would actually put in to playing Assassin's Creed Origin. I'm super excited about it. I'm super stoked. I can't wait for it because this is...
Medicine is the wondrous art of healing. No harm will come to your friend.
They are even not. The only reason they have to do it is to like get bombed. Like, for me, being able to play the game is so nice. It gets embedded in you. Announce it. Great that they're I even
have an entire cavalry in 13 tanks by Jean-Luc.
I'm actually genuinely excited for, like, to see everything the game has to offer. Like,
we go man off. Have a good day, sir.
Immersive.
Officer, stop! Have you left
your heard that the combat is going to be similar to that of Unity. And also, they're putting the locking into Origin, which, like, that could actually come in handy. I mean, it's better than having to do the old days, like, hold the button, and then...
Scherzo! Get down!
He is not what he says.
Borgia just stand there and like, get down, and I'm like, weapons, you can customize everything. I mean, it's not going to be like Unity where, you know, you can have like a custom top, a custom belt, a custom hood. No. But apparently there's something where Balak can grow a beard. That's cool. I mean, if I could put a beard on him from the get-go, that'd be neat. But I do also like listening to the theories that people have. Because, you know, normally a lot of the theories do have a good deal of relevance. Like, for instance, the scar that Desmond has, he's like,
the world itself
Balak has
is
that
unchanging.
Same scar.
We must change to understand
could
it.
Could it be possible that
its secrets
Balak
will only be revealed through a careful study of the truth?
That's you.
But we have been taught incorrect theories by great men who were limited by archaic tools and beliefs.
But
we live
he
in a time of progress.
Relevance.
Take your
help to
seriously, good boy. Every day new breakthroughs
be
are made.
Best.
But when we look to the sky,
I guess the one thing that they don't really like to do is keep going back
to
Desmond. I mean, let's look at the facts first. Desmond's story progressed from AC1 to
AC3.
So yeah, AC1 to AC3, that was Desmond's story. Four... Rogue. Well, Rogue was different. Rogue was more with Abstergo, basically, it's either you join the Templars or you get shot. It's either you join or you die. Either way, that's not really very good things. Anywho, Unity and Syndicate, you follow. Actually, I think it's mainly Syndicate. No, Unity, you're watching these pictures and whatnot, and then Syndicate, you're following Sean and Rebecca. But you know, they are beloved characters. I still remember playing AC2 when you first meet Sean. Sean is such an asshole. I mean, Sean is just a jerk. But then by Syndicate, Sean's not really much of a jerk anymore. Now he's got a weapon. Taser. Rebecca's actually got a weapon. Sean has got a taser. I mean, sure, tasers could be effective, but could a taser kill somebody instantly? I don't think so. No. But primarily, the modern day story so far, I mean, this is still scratching my brain, is the modern day to Assassin's Creed Origins. They're talking about it potentially being a trilogy. Maybe. I don't know. The new protagonist. Some potential sort of resemblance to the Miles family line. If so, cool. If not, yeah. But give us a third person modern day narrative story. Let us do like we did in 2 Brotherhood Revelation. Actually, no, Revelation, you were in the Animus. Your mind was stuck in the Animus in Revelation. So your mind was stuck. And yeah, so the mind was stuck. You had to get to a sync nexus so you can get out. 3, you have to do that cool puzzle thing, basically freeing Juno. And I know how Syndicate ended, where it's just like Juno is still in power. What's going to be a relevance in the modern day about her lover Aita? Because those are a couple other things that I was researching that that might have some correlation, that the main protagonist, or better yet, Desmond's son, if he is the actual protagonist of this game, could be a well, obviously Blood of a Sage, that goes without saying, a descendant of Aita. Which, if that is the case, that's a little screwed up. Still interesting. I don't know. I mean, the more you look at it, and the more that I think about it, is like the more that I'm thinking to myself, like, I gotta know. What's this modern day gonna be about? What is it gonna be covering? How is it going to tie in to everything else? Because even though that this new game is going to be a standalone title, it's got to tie into the others somehow. So all the other ones, well, the game itself tied in, modern day, not so much. I mean, the Desmond storyline, that tied into its own thing. So you had Altair bin Lahad, Ezio Auditore da Firenze, Connor Ratahadegon, Haytham, which Haytham you did before you did Connor. But it's mainly just the storyline itself that leads this, I liked the Desmond story. I liked the quirky, smart-ass comments and all of that. But I mean, at the same token, a really good, concrete, modern-day story has been something that a lot of Assassin's Creed fans have been waiting for. Like, it's something that Assassin's Creed fans, or rather, Assassin's Creed fans I know about, that they've been wanting. That they've been wanting a concrete Assassin's Creed, like, modern-day story. Which, you know, is all well and good. It wouldn't hurt having a solid modern day story. I mean, I think that, you know, I mean, the game itself, I do believe, will be, you know, adequate enough. You know, I mean, you're gonna have a solid game story, long journey. Then you're gonna have, It's already 2:37 in the morning. Good thing I don't have to work tomorrow. Anyway, I'm guessing that just with, I mean, I'm certain that the game itself is going to be solid. Solid story. But the only thing that I really want, I mean, when it comes to Assassin's Creed, I'm not. Because I know that Ubisoft has something bigger on the way. Ubisoft has certainly done really good titles in the past, and their latest ones have been boring.
I may be expensive, but my goods are worth the extra three.
And then, like, the South Park, the Stick of Truth. Absolutely hilarious. The new title, South Park, the Fractured Butthole. You know, if you can say that to somebody, you say the title of the game how it's supposed to be said, say it to somebody, and if they can listen to it with a straight face, or without chuckling, or smiling, or hell, are you even cracking at that point? I think you just gotta know the people that just don't have the right head. Ah, boy. All the ones that I got to assassino. But, I mean, the major thing would be, I mean, I just want a good, solid story. I want a good, solid Assassin's Creed that's gonna have a very, well, very defined, like, modern-day story. I mean, to me, some people that wouldn't necessarily be important because, I mean, their normal response is, you know, it's just a game. It's just a game. Who cares? Which, you know, is true for some people, but, I mean, for me, I care. I'm a gamer. This is what I love to do. I've played every single Assassin's Creed game. They were all, like, really well executed, really well done. The first one, because, I mean, obviously being the first game, you know, with Altair, even the Ahad, the man couldn't swim. Who'd have thunk? Land in the water, you get desynchronized. Oh well. Two, Brotherhood and Revelation then became the first, you know, successful trilogy, which was good. Then they made three, which some people would disagree. Some people would, I mean, a lot of people would say, like, oh, that one sucked, that one's horrible, that was a terrible storyline, everything else. I mean, basically, to a lot of people, see, people are taking a small, tiny aspect of the game and then just signifying that it sucks. Me, personally, I think it was good. I liked it. I liked the whole, you know, take on, you know, like, the sticking Connor in this point in history, this Revolutionary War. Brain farted there for a second. Putting him in the smack middle of this, seeing George Washington, Charles Lee, then in four, you know, you got Blackbeard, you got James Kidd, you got Benjamin Hornigold, you know, you got all these historically accurate people that put into these games. So that, you know, for, you know, back when I was in high school, if there was like a history class and then if a teacher did something, I mean, this, you know, this is something I'd have a lot of respect for. Say a teacher, you know, wanted to cover, say, American history. Then they use AC3. You know, they use that game as a reference. Because, you know, it would be a way of reaching out to certain kids. Because, you know, kids nowadays, you know, they play video games. I mean, shoot. Back in the past, when I was a kid, you know, you had a Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis. You know, you had all these older ones that, you know, that were what they were. And they were great for the time that they were around. They were what they were meant to be. Which was fine, you know, how basically growing up in Rhode Island, I had a Super Nintendo. Growing up in Rhode Island, having a Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, PS2, actually, I didn't even get my hands on a PS2 till I was 10. And I'm 27 now. Hell, look at me now, 27. I've had this PS4 now for 2 years. Before that, I had a PS3. I would not have been able to do what I do today with a PS4 that I would have ever even attempted to do on the PS3. PS3 for me was just entertainment center, Blu-ray player. I mean, even sometimes for here, I use my PS4 as entertainment center, Blu-ray player. I mean, I don't really use it to play much video games because, you know, at the time, I working and everything else, and now what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be doing live broadcasts on YouTube. And then when Assassin's Creed Origin comes, I'm going to be playing it, obviously. I mean, in the comment section, I want you to let me know, should I record my... I was thinking, like, okay, how could I have done that? Just subscribe to the channel. Edit them and stuff like that. You know, it's stuff I want to do. It's stuff I like to do, but criticism is, you know, something I'd rather have. Having good vibes only, you know. Positively, no negativity. I do that with work. Really do not want any negativity. Stuff like that. Or better yet, you know, I'm usually on my phone all the time anyway. So if you guys want to talk Assassin's Creed Origin, talk Assassin's Creed in general, you'll let me know. I'll definitely sit there and chat with you guys. Because, you know, I mean, Assassin's Creed, I mean, the shirt. My toboggan. Assassin's Creed stuff. But Assassin's Creed is one of my passions. It's one of the things that I enjoy. It's something that, I mean, honestly, a dream job of mine would be going to Ubisoft Montreal or any of the major Ubisoft corporations to just sit down, thank them, shake their hands for everything that they have done. You know, especially with Assassin's Creed, you know, with every title they have gotten better and better and better. And now I cannot wait to see their latest piece of work. I think it's going to be great. I'll definitely review it and play it, obviously. I mean, how else am I supposed to review if I don't play it, right? But I just want to know what you guys think. Just, again, feel free to subscribe. Feel free to leave a comment. Give me a thumbs up if you like what I did. If you guys liked what I talked about, Again, any criticism is thankful. Anyway, just click that red subscribe button. Come hang out. Chat. I do live broad. I will be doing live broadcasts at least once a week until, you know, I start really catching a rhythm and then work from there. So, I will make an update video here soon stating like when I'm going to do a live broadcast so you guys can come hang out, you know, chat, say hi, say what's up, and you know, just good positive vibes for any of you that going on. The internet connection quality is kind of... So for any guys that have, you know, been staying to hang out, hearing everything I had to say, thank you. You know, I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, even though that this video is almost an hour long. I'll definitely be making my broadcast shorter. Shorter or longer, you know, just, again, positive criticism, comments below, just that, and I will be putting an update video up pretty soon. I will link it to my Facebook, actually, my broadcast link goes to my Facebook, so anybody on my Facebook would be able to come over to my channel and watch it, but that's besides the point. Alright, everybody. Hope you all have yourself a good day. Have a good night. Have a good day whenever you guys are watching this. And I will catch you guys next time. This is Neo Nerd Gaming, signing out.